Hi, I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. We're going to look at some vintage Bosworth rackets here. So these are pro stock rackets from Bosworth International. First up, we've got one of Mark Philippoussis' old head Prestige Classics. It features a Prestige liquid metal mid paint job on it. So where the retail version had the raised liquid metal bumps right there, the four locations in the hoop, this one just has a decal. So it looked like raised bumps on TV, but it's actually just a smooth racket there. A lot of lead tape at 3 and 9. Beautiful application, layer upon layer of lead right there. Not sure if there's any lead under the cap grommet or what's going on the handle, because we've left it intact, but it does feature the used leather and the used tourna grip overgrip. So it's just as it came off the court last time Philippoussis used this racket. Now this one is a pretty beefy racket. The unstrung weight of this one is 13.2, so you string it up, you're going to look at about a 13.8 static weight right there. It's 6 points headlight unstrung. Again, that's going to shift about 4 points, so it's going to be very close to even just 2 points headlight once it's strung up. 371 swing weight in this racket. If you put a poly in it, you're going to add about 30 points on the RDC there for swing weight, so you can look at about a 400 swing weight strung up. And then it's a 66 RA unstrung. That's going to drop down a couple of points too. So you're going to be looking at about a 64 RA on this one when it is strung and ready for the court. We have one of them, so get it while we have it. Otherwise, it's gone and some other lucky guy will have it in his racket collection. Next up, we have a really cool Prince Experimental racket. This is a TX139P-97. It's 27.5 inches long. It's only 11.5 ounces unstrung, and it has a 10 points headlight balance, even though it's got a ton, again, beautiful lead application at 3 and 9 and also around the tip of the racket there. This one goes 66 RA, a 329 swing weight, and a 16-18 string pattern. It's got a super skinny 16 to 17 millimeter beam. This racket was never made available to the public at all. And so it is a true experimental racket right there from Prince. Not sure which pro this was customized from, but I've got some ideas. I won't say any names just because, you know, we can't verify that. But there were only a few pros out there swinging the longer length rackets from Prince, and especially with the port grommet system back in the day. Next up, we've got a really cool old Pro Staff Tour 90. And I remember when this one came to market, it was one of the first racket reviews I did after the Wilson Rock. I did the Pro Staff Tour 90, and this was back in 2003. I just started at Tennis Warehouse, and this one is just a regular cosmetic a retail version of the Pro Staff Tour 90. And this one was held for testing for Nicholas Kiefer, but never put into service. So it's still in new condition, new old stock condition, should I say. And this is a great racket. It does feature a different yoke design than you'd see from the K90s going forwards. On the K90s, they extended the pallet right here and the throat of the racket up a little bit higher, made the center, the yoke, a bit more compact, and it made the racket a bit more maneuverable. And if you look back on the Wayback Machine, the web archive, you can find our old review. And if you look at the December snapshot of our website for 2003 on that machine, you can find our review, and our playtesters pretty much unanimously complained about the maneuverability of this racket. So Fed was using one that was slightly different. From K-Factor on, we've been getting pretty much the same frame design as his. Last but not least today, we have a Triad 6.0 racket here. And this one was held for testing for Todd Martin. Again, this one's in new condition, so we're not sure if he was testing these rackets or he just, you know, it was one that was held there for him to test potentially. So he may have spent some practice time with frames like this. This one is pre-production, so it does not have the production cosmetic, and it's also slightly longer, so it was never actually released in this longer length to the public. This one unstrung, again, specs are 10.8 ounces. It's got an 8 points headlight balance, 284 swing weights, so it's nice and maneuverable, a 72 RA, which is rare to get from a Triad racket. Usually the Triad system here in the throat really throws off the flex reading when you put it on the RDC, and it features my favorite string pattern, which is a 16-20, so you get a nice blend of pop from the open mains and a little bit more control from that tighter cross string section right there. All right, that's all I've got for this week's vlog. There's only one of each of these, so get them where you can.